That's
it's
the
a
scale.
pretty, it's a pretty small thing. I might bump it up and suddenly the whole world gets a lot bigger.
Mean, 10 miles
Oh my
at least.
god, Snake. Oh, you have fucking reversed the hand.
Pretty much, yeah. I just wave my fingers and the world gets
My
bigger.
god,
I create space.
that stand was so bullshit.
Like,
Wait,
how
what?
long would you want it the distance to be going this way to get to Rindelport?
Well,
Of
basically
course, traveling fast.
the miles per hour of a character in Savage Worlds is half their pace, and the average and the pace for the party is unanimous is uniformly 6. So your walking pace is 3 miles per hour.
Oh,
Yeah.
okay.
Yeah.
But I have a cart as well. I don't know if that
And that's
slows
also
us down or
not really
speeds
because
us
you're
up
walk because
or
you're
decks
on
in there.
traveled roads unless you're pulling the cart yourselves.
No, I have a horse.
Yeah. And you're fine. And it's also
That's
just
probably good then. It's a good distance.
Like it would take you most of a day's walk to get there, or a good few hours. But
It takes
yeah.
3 hours to get to the crossroads here. About
Yeah.
two, and then that's
Yeah,
like
so
all
I was.
day. Yeah.
Yeah, about 18 hours, probably.
Something like that.
Yeah.
It's like 12, and then 6 and 9-ish. And that's pretty good scale as far as like, take over a day to get to a place.
So basically, a day off of you guys were all working at the shop. You do actually get a memo from, you actually get a message from Frederick Rendell. Like the messenger gives it to you, just like go finds you at the tavern or wherever it is you're hanging out, and just says, "Okay, Frederick says he summoned you. He's worked out your end of the deal."
Oh, how lovely.
All right.
By the
Just
way,
can we have like a quick summary of what happened last session?
sure thing, yeah, because it's been a while. So, you guys, you brokered the deal between Frederick Rendell and the Wolf Pack, the deserters who fled from the Battle of the Blood Gulch
Right.
6 months earlier. And because deserters are pretty much met uniformly with capital punishment, it was a tough deal, but you managed to get Frederick Rendell to agree to make them be very, very closely watched and work as guards in the city of Holden Clearing. So, Frederick Rendell made this deal basically knowing that his reputation will get sullied if anything goes wrong, so they're on a very, very tight leash, and if one of them steps out of line, all of them will be punished.
Right.
And because
Oh
you were the one who
no.
brokered the deal, you had to agree to do one task of Frederick Rendell's choosing when he wants it done, or else they're shit out of luck.
Right.
Then you
Okay.
guys went and worked in a shop. Some ghost boats, some ghost capsules broke.
Yes.
Taking over furniture, you fought it in a valiant battle. One of you decided to punch a bookshelf.
Yeah, or some
Oh!
understanding.
I'm suffering, wizard.
So we should probably get
God, you've got to
his.
hand it to him.
Oh, fuck
Oh.
you!
Break his hand as well.
I'm out of this. Nope, this game is over.
We
I'm
should probably go
crashing.
get that hand fixed.
Oh, you did try and fix it. You were able to basically bandage it up, and suddenly it's a fracture. It's not completely fucked. It's not like he's never gonna use it again.
I'm never gonna be able to shoot a bow ever again.
I mean, his left hand's
Jesus.
okay. He just needs to have like a hand crossbow or something for a week.
My disgrace. Disgrace.
So, because the two of us have one wound still, you said that that'll take about a week to
I think,
solve.
oh no, it's 5 days, I believe, is time of healing.
Okay. Is that 5 days of bed rest or just 5 days in
Just
general?
5 days in general.
Okay.
Nice.
It doesn't say anything about, like, don't work hard, don't operate heavy machinery.
Because that's all I do is operate heavy machinery.
A wizard's
Yes.
life.
Yeah.
It's
Just go
hard
work in the
life.
factories. Thug life. The
Yes, the
magic
medieval
magic factories.
factories.
All right, so are we like how much time is better? We're just leaving the shop, or
that's up to you. Do you want to like wait a day? But basically, you are gonna get a message, from Frederick Rundell, as that kind of scene demonstrated.
It doesn't matter to me how long it's been.
Yeah, you don't exactly just walk out the shop and there's a guy waiting there with, like,
right.
a scroll.
Maybe we go back to the bar and just, like, chill for a while. Mm. Trying to get over what just happened. And then we get the message or whatever.
Mm.
My hand is suffering.
But yeah,
you can hand off your rodent.
That was a very weird and laggy.
Yes.
I picked up
Rodan.
Yeah. It was a hand joke, so.
Strange noises coming from Solaire's armor there.
Maybe he is a lizard person.
Agreed, Solaire. Agreed.
Stupid microphone.
All is.
Did it happen again?
An airtight suit of armor that requires, like, an internal PA system.
You do notice that regulars who before did kind of treat you either with warmth or respect are now kind of like eyeing you suspiciously.
Like, me in particular, or just the group as a whole?
It's mainly pointed at you, but the whole group, because you were with the bandits that morning. They're kind of shying away from your table. The only one who's treating you kind of normally is the bartender.
I was going to say, I want to ask the bartender, like, how the people are taking their new guards.
He kind of, like, looks across at you and says, same as anything, they feel threatening. Pretty much.
All talk has been
whether you've lost your fucking marbles.
It's not the first time that people have thought of me that way.
Surprise.
It was a big
demonstration. I'm sure it'll all work out in time.
Hopefully. I mean, they've been given a second chance, let's just hope they're not stupid enough to throw it away.
Indeed.
But, yeah, it might be a good thing, you know? If all the villagers are paranoid about you, then they won't be suspicious of the new guys. Well, as much.
That sounds nice. My hand.
What a lovely bunch.
Yeah, I just look over to Orlin, tip my glass up, and say, yeah, now it's a week in the life of me. I'm gonna take a drink.
Maybe after we do the mayor's task, we might have to think about moving somewhere else for a while.
Yeah, get the fuck out of Dodge like I was intending to 3 weeks ago.
What? Stop.
I think this has all taken place over the course of like 4 days so far.
Yeah, 3 weeks ago.
longer than 3 weeks.
What stopped you from us leaving?
I had no easy way of moving all my possessions.
You live here, don't you?
I want it noted, the first game took place on the 4th of October, it's now the 7th of October.
God.
You guys have not stopped and rested, I should be giving you like, I mean you've rested, yeah, but you should be getting like fucking endurance penalties.
Well, we stayed the night at one point. We slept at one point in the last 4 days.
Sleep has been had.
Yeah, I mean, I slept in the wizard's wagon.
Yeah, no, I'm kidding. So yeah, basically the bar, it's basically a lot more talk. No, it's not on fire, not yet. If you're in a campaign, at least one bar will be set on fire, but not now, maybe not this one. There are many bars in this one.
Just making sure.
Just so you all know. My favourite thing to do in a scene is to say it on fire.
It's true. It's very true. And it kills old men with it.
At least it's not a boat. With the bar, at least you can just leave.
Say, wizard, have you ever been on a boat?
Well, boats tend to catch on fire.
The general atmosphere of the bar tonight is it's very busy, but the conversation is all kind of hushed.
Right. Boats don't catch on fire. People light boats on fire. It's just because they're made of wood.
Listen, an old friend of mine once said that there's two things that you avoid, and that's cellars and boats.
He's got the right of it.
Yeah. I actually met a fella once who was on a boat. Drifted ashore. Wore a similar armor to you, Sakart? No, Solier.
Yeah. Was it?
He was mumbling something about a burned man. Weird fella. Walked off. Never saw him again.
Huh.
You Very pointed strange. That to the one person who would not get that.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. It's very strange.
Let me just pull out my tabletop Pokemon cards and show him.
I remember once I was in a cellar, pipes up the barman, then some twat was sitting upstairs just started throwing all of his potions at the monster in there. Didn't even know what they did.
You know, sometimes you're just in a situation where you have no choice.
No choice but to fucking do something really stupid.
One of those potions could have lit the thing on fire and the problem would have been solved.
Definitely.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but instead it made it invisible and turned it into concrete, and then it would have been invisible, concrete, and on fire.
No one important died in that situation.
Yeah, but you think everyone would have. Strange.
Yeah, God must have been going easy on us.
Yeah.
Scratch my beard. Strange.
he grabs the bottle of rum that says Ithacan brand rum and puts it beneath the counter and says, well, enough of that talk.
Okay, I get that.
There's a logo of a man in a pink suit covered in gems on the bottle.
It's all connected.
I'm just reading one of the daily funnies. It's about a failed illusionist.
Oh yeah, what's his name?
I think his name was Steve.
Oh yeah, I like that.
Steve.
Okay, I'm ready to see what the mayor is on about.
Yeah, Valdal, yeah. the guy behind the bar, says, yeah, this has been a very bizarre conversation.
I swear, this happens like once every so often. One of these just happens. All right, let's go see what the mayor has to say.
Yeah, we're off to see the mayor.
So, the new mayor?
So is this the same evening, like, off. you left the shop?
I don't think so.
Maybe in the morning?
Maybe in the next morning. Okay, yeah. So
it's
quite a nice morning, even though it is lightly snowing. So, streets are pretty kind of empty. Like, most people are packed into the bar. Everyone else is basically at work.
Orlin sort of hikes up his robe. You know, you can see his sandals and socks, and he's avoiding the bigger patches of snow as we walk through the town.
You walk past, like, another a lady in a long wizard robe, and she kind of hikes up the robe, revealing socks and sandals. Is that the in thing for wizards at this time? I don't know. I might have just made it.
Yeah, it's high fashion.
Mm.
Isn't that basically Tinder, but for wizards?
It used to be, like, wide-brimmed glasses, but now it's the socks and sandals.
You wizards are strange.
And before that, it was plucked eyebrows.
It's something about being a wizard that gives you a skewed fashion sense.
You're just ahead of the curve.
What curve?
Way past the curve.
A fashion
just going in a straight line.
This all started when the Wizard's Tower, which does have a school built into it, also shared it with a fashion school. And an art school, and it all just kind of became a jumbled mess.
There's actually a secret council member that's the pink, and they come up with all the fashion necessities.
Joke what you want, I'm writing that down right now. I'm calling it Magnifico the Pink.
He's behind everything.
That's a good one.
Oh my god.
This bastard's behind everything, all of it.
The madman.
There needs to be a wizard with dwarf in his name as well.
All right, so Gandalf, the two-story kind of town center. and you're let through right away. There's not many people waiting to see the mayor at this point.
Sweet, are you fucking serious, Gandorf?
Yes.
Is the same reception as before?
Oh, this time he looks slightly happier. Still looks really pissed off, as he seems to perpetually do, but...
Oh, he seems to have changed genders.
Hey, I'm talking about the mayor. You're let right through.
Oh, no, I was asking if it's the same receptionist as before.
Oh, I thought you said same reception as before.
Yeah.
Ah, like she's the same.
Okay.
Evening.
Barely registers you.
Yeah, I take my hat off when we enter the mayor's room.
He looks up. Ah, and you've brought your friends. Perfect. I have a feeling you're going to need them for this.
We were allowed to bring friends, right?
What is the task that you require of me?
Have you ever heard of New Stonehome?
I don't know, GM. Have I ever heard of Stonehome?
Oh, of course you haven't.
Of course I haven't.
Of course you haven't.
Of course.
It's an old piece of Rendell history. A few hundred years ago, Wilbur Goldson wanted to commission the grandest castle ever made. Made in reverence of the Rendells. Unfortunately, it was very, very, very expensive. Terrifically so. But it was made to try and show up those dwarves. And he pulls out a map which actually has it marked. Marked location just south of Verne Keep.
Okay. I sort of lean over the map and nod.
You see, it was meant to be completely self-sustained, a city unto itself, funded and built by one man. Wilbur Goldson was one of the richest of the time, had his hands everywhere, mining, real estate, he had ships going far and wide. But he sank everything into this castle. He had people, the greatest experts the world over, designing the place, figuring out how to get it to be self-sustainable, moving animals up there. Architects, builders, everyone.
200 years ago, you said?
Longer than that, centuries.
I must have still been in my blue phase.
How old are you?
I just sort of cough and let's continue, please.
Anyway, what I want is I want the scepter of Wilbur Goldson. When it fell through, he bankrupted his whole noble house trying to build this castle and didn't even get one-tenth of the way through the planned construction. What's up there is an entrance hall, an old castle, and a manor that he had built for visiting Rendells.
Mm-hmm.
He left his scepter behind as a gesture for exiting high society. It was, as he described it, his greatest failing. The Rendells took construction of the castle over from him and allowed him and his direct and his immediate descendants to live in relative comfort for the rest of their lives.
What makes you think the scepter's still there?
It was left as a sign of respect to the man.
Is that what you want? Is that the task? You want the scepter?
I want the scepter. Come hell or high water, I want that scepter.
And you need a wizard for this.
I couldn't ask many others to do it. Most would not dare touch it. And I need this to be done off the books.
Why is that? What is the problem with the area?
Well, no one's been up there to inspect it for quite some time. Let me explain it this way. I want that scepter because I want to know what's going on up there. So that scepter is a sign that you made your way in.
I see.
So we're to siege a keep, then, and ransack it for a scepter.
Well, it might be empty. You won't know until you get there.
Yes.
Scratching my chin and say, empty.
The scepter, is it just a royal trinket, or does it have properties?
It's a trinket. At the time, scepters were a fashion statement, let's say. You had one, you were a member of the upper classes.
Oh, believe me, I know of fashion statements.
I'm sure you do, bloody wizards.
Those wizards.
He just kind of like leans over and looks at your feet. Well, probably obscured by the rope.
I want to just mention that my sandals, they look really plain, but they're actually like alligator skin or something. Something ridiculous. They're like open-toed alligator skin sandals with socks.
And they glow in the dark at night.
They're also like bedazzled with little gems.
Wait, so hold on. Are they like flip-flops? You know, they got like the toe thong going on? Or are they like the ones that are like the strap ones? Like the Velcro ones that have like.
I want to say like the Velcro ones, the ones that kind of like wrap around the back of your foot.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So he's not wearing flippies with socks. Yeah. He's got the full on like Velcro sandal socks.
Yeah, you can like see the socks between the little bits of leather.
Yep. Nice.
I sort of wiggle my toes at him.
He kind of like he climbs back over his desk. Well, leans back, sits in his chair. Just looks. So, do you believe you'll be able to do this?
Oh, are these, are they toe socks, or are they, like, mitten socks?
That's a good question, actually. This is important for the canon of, Orlin.
I mean,
are they toe
wiggling,
socks?
If you're wiggling toes at him.
Yeah, I want to say that, you know, the normal fashion statement is socks and sandals, but I've elevated it to, like, toe socks.
Nice. Does each toe have a different color?
No. It's just white socks. Okay, so what was he saying?
He just got like, leans back. He's very unimpressed.
Don't worry, we'll besiege this place.
Yeah, he's just,
we'll do what we can.
Right. Now, there is a little niggle with all this.
Hmm?
I want assurance that you'll have this done, so I'm setting you a time limit.
Oh.
You have 20 days.
Ah.
I'm sure you'll be able to do it in that time. It's, what, barely a day's walk? Now, he does look over at the wrapped hand of Alter and says, that might be an issue, but you're well within time.
He's fine.
Is there a key or anything like that we need with us? Like a lock for the doors or anything like that?
Any old defenses may have fallen apart by this time. But it never hurts to be prepared. If you're worried about scaling the mountain, you need not worry. They carved stairs out leading up there. They're not well kept, surely, but they are stairs.
Just to be clear, when we do this for you, my debt is paid.
Your debt is paid, and those criminals will only ever be responsible for themselves.
Good.
I just
we have
would like
no
to remind you, the coin that I gave you, this is a magically binding agreement. It wouldn't do well to go back on it.
Oh, I'm a man of my word.
Very well, then we shall do as you say.
Where did you come from? I referenced your broken hand.
What? Sweet, you missed the conversation about alligator sandals and toe socks.
Oh my god.
We determined that they are in fact toe socks.
No. This is the revelation that breaks Alter. Everything else about the mission is okay, but it's those damn shoes.
I bow to the mayor and do a little flourish with my hat, and then I leave.
You just kind of hear him mutter bloody wizards again as you exit. Even though he does appreciate being bowed to, because doesn't get that as often as he'd like.
Altar just does that typical, you know, one hand up and it's like, boy.
No bloody respect.
Boy.
Oh, by the way, Orlin, Rosrick said he wanted to see you again.
Ah, good.
He's still in town for a day or two, so...
I see he's finally woken up from his beating.
Yes, he seemed rather solemn.
Okay, in that case, I guess I head that direction after we leave.
So yeah, what are you guys going to do? You've got 20 days to nick a scepter.
Yeah, Yeah, kill our shit. Very, very apt.
Yeah. So, you mentioned the terrain is quite sort of mountainous. I suspect we may need a couple of things to help us scale it, just in case.
Wait.
They say the path is quite old.
What is the wizard, Red Wizard's name again?
Grosrick.
I'm really bad with names.
Yeah, Grosrick, that's fine. Right? I'll give you a list, because I'm terrible with names as well.
Yeah, before I started thinking about a plan, I went ahead over there and see what he wants.
So, basically, I'll just say for Matt, he told you that he was, like, in a small kind of bakery that has kind of a place to sit down.
Oh my god. I'm sorry, look at Discord.
Oh my god.
That
is 100% accurate, except they're white socks and not blue socks.
Alright, well, I'm opening that in...
Oh.
There we go. For the record.
Okay.
There are running shoes that look like those socks. Apparently very comfortable,
like the
but...
dumb, like, ninja socks that just have, like, the big toe separated.
The one thing I will say, though, is you can't see them unless I actually raise my robes up.
Oh, yeah, and that's when I start making fright checks for NPCs.
Yes.
There we go. There we go.
It's like my my character in our Warhammer 40k game, except to, like...
Snake.
Instead of my third eye melting their faces off, it's my sandals.
There we go, guys. I changed the picture for this group.
Yes.
That's a lot more. Now I'll know how to spot it immediately.
Snake, this campaign also doesn't have a picture.
It doesn't. I'll fix it at some point.
So, right. Sorry to interrupt.
It's fine. No, he's just kind of like sitting down and like... There's a kind of... like, balcony thing over a little eating area outside a bakery, and he's just kind of sitting in there, just with eating a bread roll with the most forlorn look on his face. That's how you find Grosrick.
I take a sit next to him, and I sort of pat his shoulder. How's it going, my old friend?
Not terribly well. Just getting beaten up by that crazed religious nut made me realize something.
Where is Solaire doing this, by the way?
Hopefully not nearby.
I've gone out to get some rope and stuff.
Oh my god, Jax.
Is that your new adventuring band, by the way?
Yes, that's my current group.
Altair is holding up his broken hand.
I'm slowly dying.
Yeah.
You need to have, like, the name of each wizard below each pair of socks.
Yes.
Okay, so, I'm like, yes, this is my my current band. They're good people.
Good people. They seem disparate, but... No, it's just... I used to work for the War Council of the Rendells. That was what I'd worked my whole life for.
I remember.
This position doesn't quite lend me the same gravitas that I'm used to. And getting beaten up by that wanderer was something I hadn't expected. I trained my whole life for things like that, and he just walks in and does that to me.
In your defense, you gave him quite the row as well, you know?
Yes.
It wasn't an easy fight.
I will admit, he was a tough opponent, but yes, I got a few good wallops in. But no, I have lost the respect of the militia, and it's kind of shameful to say, but I'm glad I'll be leaving here in a couple of days. It'll give them time to forget. And look, let me just cut to the chase. This isn't about my self-pity. I think that if the dwarves were to attack, and if they didn't go directly for Vern Keep, Holden Clearing would fall.
Oh, no!
I suspect there's some truth in what you say. That's part of the reason why I pushed so hard for the bandits to join the guard.
And that was a good move. Not many people would have seen how wise it is to bring deserters back in, but... Well, you're one of a kind on that front.
But wait, wizard, would they really do that? Would they invade a settlement?
Well,
are you new here?
Yeah, but hey, my name is Altar, and he holds out his hand. Which hand was broken, by the way?
The right hand.
Yeah, he holds it out to shake, but it's like all bandaged and stuff. Oh.
You don't want me shaking that hand.
It's been a while since originally I came from the Dwarven Lands and I was, doing diplomacy and stuff there. But do I still have a general sense of if they would attack Holden Clearing or that sort of thing?
You do know that they would attack Holden Clearing. Basically,
probably if they had some kind of profit out of it.
In a straight, the dwarves' sense of pride is that they want the whole landmass. Basically, even if the humans could not possibly fight back and they were just pushed back to Grosvenor's Basket South with no army, the dwarves would attack it, or they would harass it at the least.
Okay, so going back to talking, what do you have any ideas then for ways we could prepare the place if that were to happen?
Well, every mayor has to have a mercenary retainer on hand. Some mercenary company that swears gold guards to them so that they may be able to defend themselves better. Frederick Rendell has the money for that, but he refuses to spend it. He says he's got some design that he's holding money back for. He would not tell me what, and I'm not in a position to press him.
Maybe
so you would rather he spent the money on mercenaries, as you say, to help bolster the defenses?
Yes, because he's also he's trying to bolster the militia as much as possible, but that's both because he's young, foolish, and cheap.
Right, I see.
He's going to cripple this town's economy if he keeps doing it that way. No, he needs mercenaries, and he needs them en masse right this moment, if this town is to feel secure.
Oh boy.
What was the place called? New Stonehome?
New Stonehome,
I'm like, what do you know of New Stonehome? Does that ring any bells?
That's an old keep. Wilbur Goldson wanted to make it centuries ago. It's a small story, but essentially his idea was it was a gift to the Rendell, but he also knew of the dwarf's sense of pride. Let me put it this way. You're in charge of the war effort. You push the dwarves back into their mountain, back into old Stonehome. There's no possible way they could fight back at that point. What would you do in that situation to the dwarves?
Taunt them?
I'm not sure.
It's a tricky question, isn't it? Would you let them live? Would you try and make them a vassal? Try and soften things over now that you know there's no possible way to fight back? Or would you throw hundreds upon hundreds, if not thousands upon thousands, of lives away trying to attack something that is completely impregnable?
I have a feeling that they did the last thing.
Well, that's No. This is a hypothetical.
This
is if the dwarves were pushed back. But Wilbur Goldson understood the dwarves' sense of pride. That they could sack Rendell Port. They could sack Verne Keep. They could take everything from us. But if humans were left in New Stonehome, the dwarves would throw every life away trying to sack it. That castle has no offensive qualities. It's not a good place to put troops to move them on. It is the last resort. But if we were alive up there, the dwarves would throw everything at it and they would fail. That was the idea of New Stonehome.
I see. Well, the mayor wants us to scout the place and find out what we can about it.
That's not a bad plan, and that gives me some idea what the money is for, at least. At least I fucking hope it isn't that.
What do you think it could be for?
The richest man in the country at the time bankrupted himself trying to make the place. Whatever coppers he's got squirreled away would not be enough to make it functional. That's what I'm thinking, anyway.
Maybe he's just looking for, I don't know, maybe some hidden MacGuffin in there.
Maybe.
He does want us to find a scepter.
Yes, but those are just ceremonial relics. They're not like our scepters.
Maybe it's a so war he says. Scepter.
So he says. Maybe there was something to it. The richest man in the time might have had something like that. But he gave it up willingly, so...
Well, you said you're leaving in a few days.
Yeah, I've checked the town's defensive capabilities. I've got a complete registry of how many hands are ready to fight, of the militia, of the nobles still in town. My work here is pretty much done, and I can report this back to the Wizards' Council. And I'll also need to pass this information on to the War Council, which... By the way, have you heard about the Blue?
What about him?
He's working for the War Council now, which really annoys me.
That's strange.
Yes. Especially because his position has nothing to do with war. Everyone at the tower is really against it, but everyone else thinks he's smart enough to handle both roles perfectly.
Hmm.
You might want to look into that. I mean, he's abrasive, but he seems to give you the time of day, at least, Orlan.
Oh, most of the members of the council do at some point. Well, listen, we're heading up to Vern Keep soon. Perhaps you could travel with us on your way to Rendell.
Oh, that wouldn't be too bad. And if you're passing, and then I could show you the way to the stairs up to New Stonehome if you wish.
Ah, that would be most helpful.
Stairs?
Do you have any recommendations for things we might need?
Okay, well, it's an old keep, pretty dark and musty. Most of the flooring is made of wood, and, well, it's not been treated for several hundred years, so...
Write this down, Kodo.
So, it's going to catch on fire at some point, is what you're saying?
It's either going to catch on fire, or it'll be so musty and damp that the floor will fall through.
Probably both.
I'd take lights, torches. The front door may be jammed, so... You might want to look for a way to scale a castle wall. That's really up to you, though.
Scaling? Is it high up?
Oh, it's, I'd say... He kind of strokes his beard a bit. Well, the castle's design is old. Maybe 40, 50 feet tall wall?
Mm-hmm.
I stroke my beard harder than he stroked his beard.
He strokes his beard even harder. It's like a beard off.
We start staring at each other, stroking our beards.
Alright, well, roll spirit.
Oh god, my worst thing. Alright.
I'm picturing Jan, was it?
Let's go.
Pai Mei from Kill Bill.
Oh, I got a 6!
You got a 6, let's see what his spirit gets him. This is basic info. Oh, his spirit's a d6 as well.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Feel it. It's kind of an awkward stare off you both stroking beards with increasing intensity. You hear kind of like...
I can just imagine Alter Galen just like looking between us like, what is going on?
And all he does is like, he kind of looks and then like grabs what he would have a beard.
And a Benny falls out of his beard as he accidentally plucks a hair out.
I put it into my beard.
So Benny's are actual
things. Oh, for wizards, they are.
For wizards, yeah, none of you can see it. Only he can see the Bennies.
Yeah, for me, like, Bennies are an actual meta magic thing that actually exists.
He accidentally plucks a hair out. Ow. Okay, enough of that. But, yeah, so I'll gladly travel with you on the way to Vern Keep. Granted, I'm headed to Rendell Port afterwards. I'm not quite sure my next stop will be. But,
good.
Save for the green, everyone else is going to be in Rendell Port. Well, and for you, of course.
I would likely continue on to Rendell Port, except we have a bit of a time limit on this task, so I will likely head back to Holden Clearing.
Right. I don't think there's any important business anytime soon unless something comes up. The last 6 months have been rather hectic since the battle. Well, the first month anyway. Then it's just been kind of a standstill.
The battle?
Well, do write to me, old friend, if something changes.
I will do. And I have notaries and such to keep word out.
Okay, so I want to... I sort of, like, nod and, you know, bow my head and all that, and then I want to go meet up with the rest of the group, whatever they're doing.
I think Alta was with you.
Yeah.
Solaire was buying rope, so let's cut to Solaire. So...
You're gonna... the bondage shop.
Yeah. Yep. Which this town has, it's right next to the potion shop, because
yeah.
Go to oh, one, then you need the other.
Yeah.
As you do.
Burn. Yep.
God. Just, so you just see a man in full plate armor just like rifling through rope. Just thinking, this is going to end well.
This is a good rope.
This rope is sufficiently ropey enough for our needs.
I look around.
Hey,
the
do you have a grappling hook somewhere?
Okay, so is it Zakhart and Solaire that are in the rope shop?
Yeah, we both go.
Okay, what did you say you were spoken over then?
No, I look over to Solaire and I hold up a shovel and I'm like, hey, this one looks good. Might need that.
Yeah, I'm looking for grappling hooks as well, so I'm like, okay, rope. What else do we need? Oh, yes, one of these. Can I have
just like shoves a grappling hook in his bag?
I pick up a flint and steel and toss it into my cart.
Okay.
I'm going to need one of these.
This is like a supermarket now.
Yeah, this is the castle scaling shop. Doesn't get much business, but...
No prices!
There's like some pleasant elevator music going on in the background.
Like a nice little old lady stood behind the counter just like, oh, you want to scale a wall?
Is this the appropriate timeline for a crowbar?
Pry bars have been a thing for a really long time, so...
They have the name Wrecking Bars in England, which I quite like.
I pick up a crowbar, a wrecking bar, and a pry bar and throw them into my cart.
Oh, so, yes.
A wrecking bar.
No.
He gets all three.
Yeah. You see, he's one of those consumers that thinks that's a different thing.
Oh, wait. What's the survivalist one that's like half crowbar, half axe?
Oh, I don't know what the name of those are.
Oh, yeah.
Hang on, I've got to find the gear page. Actually, I'm guessing, Damascus, you had the gear page since you had prices.
Yep, I've got it. Page 56 on my PDF I have.
Hey, Wizard, do you think it was wise to leave them buying
stuff? I don't think groveling will get you it for free.
No, I think the item is called a grovel. The, like...
I know,
a
crovel. I was...
I see.
Making a bad pun.
Yeah, I want to find a crovel.
Alright, well, you're in a very small town, but roll... what the fuck would the check be for this? What exists, but it's by the back.
Clearly gambling is the check.
Gambling.
Clearly gambling. I'm just looking over your skills right now, just to... Just figure out what is most adept, but not far. Okay, it's a notice check.
Oh, wow. No, that looks cool, that shovel.
Yeah, it's
that's a cool shovel.
Oh, yeah, that's cool.
So roll notice.
Roll notice to see if they have a crovel.
It's like an army shovel.
Isn't that like the default one
like
in
trench,
Killing Floor?
It's like a trench shovel or whatever it's called.
Raiden will use it.
Damn, I only got a 3.
There's no crovels about, or at least none that you notice.
Hey, there, young man.
That's okay. One of my spells is summon grovel.
Oh, perfect.
Man, it's really weird how specific these get.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know, wizards, you know. They just spell for every occasion.
I mean, some wizards specialize in that, that's just
Yeah, it's that
spell.
One specific spell. Like, every spell has, like, a history of like hundreds of years of like one wizard studying that one spell to get it to work right, and so there's just one wizard who summoned the crovel for his entire life.
I imagine that wizard was actually staring at a pickaxe, a shovel, and a hatchet, and was
what could I do to these three things?
He sneezed, and suddenly they all became one item.
Spent the rest of his life working out of that app and trying to recreate
that sneeze. Actually, you know, fuck it. Kodo is actually with Zakhart.
Alright, yeah, he's just riding on my shoulder. I pick up a rope and show it to him. Good rope?
Kodo just shakes his head, no.
Alright, not good rope.
Kodo's doing things like he's trying to, like, kind of nibble in your ear, or what, he's trying to get attention. Look at that nice ferret food.
I pick up a flask. Good flask?
Yeah.
Yeah, great flask. And I don't put it in my cart. I shove it in my jacket.
So wow. this is like, all right, I'm going to change. It's not a little old lady. It's a really, really, like, wise old. And old man behind the counter. And his shop, his shop is called the Coot and Loot.
Wow. What?
Wow.
So, in that case, I glance back at the counter, notice who it is, and I'm like, no, I know this guy. And I take it out
you
of my
you don't
want
to mess with that guy.
Put it back where it was. Oh, yeah, I know him. I've heard. He's caught many thieves, and I've put them all in prison.
I wonder.
In his younger days, he was the fucking... He was the fucking fear of every criminal.
Actually, what are ferrets' favorite food?
Isn't it nuts? Oh, no.
I think I've been liking,
like... Probably, like, bugs or something.
Mm. Yeah. Like bugs?
Ferrets are probably herbivores. I liked carrots.
What do ferrets eat?
Maybe I'm wrong.
Actually, no. Fuck it. Kodo's gonna be a shit snake.
They're carnivores.
Yeah.
Snake.
Yeah, but, so that's why I was assuming that they would eat bugs and stuff.
Kodo's gonna be a shit heel. No surprise there.
Okay. Are there a bunch of socks being sold or something?
Kind of like very, very thick, warm ones for traveling in mountainous and cold regions. Like
Time to roll stealth as see if Kodo managed to snatch a pair.
Oh my god, you shit heel.
Fuck!
What?
Wow.
So Kodo just like
just
hops onto the shelf, grabs a pair of them, and just starts like trying to pull them, but they're thick, heavy socks and they're bundled up. And he just like he pulls it off the shelf and collapses. There's a loud smack on the floor, and basically what happens is he's dragged it to the door, and then Kodo looks up and notices that the old man was just watching him do that every step of the way.
This old man's actually Batman, but he's retired.
And he's pointing a bow and arrow in Kodo's direction.
So, okay, hold on. So if Kodo has been riding on my shoulder, and he hops off to try to, like, start moving socks, I'm like, Kodo, that's a bad idea. And I just reach to pick him up before he, like, manages to scamper off with it.
Yeah, alright, I'm fine with that. Yeah, but basically, you just notice that the old man saw exactly what he was doing.
Instead of putting him on my shoulder, I toss him in, like, a bag.
He moves.
Like you stay in there.
Kodo does not like this.
He leans on the counter. So are you here for ferret food, or are you actually going to buy something?
I look over to Solaire and point to his cart where hiking supplies.
Hiking. Alright, we can do you well on that one. You got crowbars, you got fucking climbing gear, you got rope.
Yeah, there's rope in there.
And you want a grappling hook. Those are in back, so give me 2 seconds and don't let that ferret touch shit. Just...
Don't worry, he's in the bag.
Yeah, he heads in back, comes back with a couple of grappling hooks. These will do you fine. I scaled many a castle wall with these bastards back in the day.
Fantastic. Solaire will be paying for it.
I'm sure he will.
Oh, and give me some of your strongest fire water you got back there. We'll need it for the trip. Stay warm.
You're one of those adventurers, right?
Alcoholism.
So he just,
staple.
Again, he goes into the back, comes out, and just in a kind of very literal definition of fire water, he just gives you something that's been magically treated, as in when you put your hand near the screw cap, which somehow exists at this point in time. You feel the heat emanating.
Ah, perfect.
Now, these will set you back and get you 3 bottles for 10 gold.
Easy. And I reach into a different pouch and give them 10 gold.
Perfect.
Yeah, this place we're going to is definitely not going to set on fire or anything.
Now,
hope not.
Basically, you can drink these, it'll keep you warm for a good long time. Stick a rag in it, set it on fire, it'll keep whoever you throw at it good and warm for a very long time. For the rest of their lives.
No, it hasn't been 24 hours yet. I don't need to take a drink.
But yeah, if you spend the money, Tim, you get your rope, you get your grappling hooks. And of course you're buying... Who's buying crowbars? Was it both of you, or...?
It's all on Solaire's tab.
Yeah, it's all on Solaire's tab.
Okay, yeah, you're paying for a crowbar as well. One crowbar is 10 gold. Or 10 cost. Alright, so just...
In monies.
Let's never actually settle on what the money is. Because, of course, we've also got that weird wizard currency.
Let's call it Ruples.
Ruples, fine. Alright.
MO money.
I do like the Swedish name for money. I do like Kronor.
Kronor.
Yeah. Or Kronor. Singular and plural.
Alright,
surely in this universe the money is called Orlans, and they have little pictures of me on them.
Maybe one day.
That's just your special wizard currency.
That's actually what the bennies look like.
You spend money for good luck.
We actually use Republican credits here.
But you're literally not a republic. As a fucking monarch.
Yeah, that's why... No, actually, that's why Republican credits are no good here.
Ah. So, yeah, basically... still got a broken hand, still on a wound, but what are you guys gonna do? You've got 20 days, you've got a bunch of climbing equipment. Grosrick is, like, waiting on you guys to leave.
I want to talk to... I just pull Alter Galen aside and I ask him, how's your hand doing, friend?
Still broken. Could've been worse.
We can either... we have a hard limit of 20 days. We can wait some time, but not very long. It's going to take us at least a day or two to get there and to get back.
Snake, how long will it take for my hand to heal, approximately?
Well, in 5 days you get a vigor check. Yeah, we'll have accommodation. That tavern you've been drinking in, the Weary Woodsman, is also an inn.
Is Vernkeep a like small town, or is it literally like just a like military outpost?
Vernkeep is actually kind of the it's kind of the cultural center, actually. Like, okay, it's mostly theaters and libraries and such. It's actually one of the poshest cities.
So it's actually a city, then?
Yeah.
Okay.
It is technically small in Holden Clearing. It's less sprawling, but more dense, if that makes sense.
Well, okay. Alto says, you know, I've been out in the wild with, like, a broken leg before. This is fine. Nothing's gonna attack us. We'll be fine.
Is there anything I can do to speed up his vigor check?
Not really, unless you have, like,
you
have greater healing.
Yeah, if I had a spell, I could probably do it, but I don't have any healing spells.
Yeah.
Okay, well, in that case, I look at him, I nod, and I say, but I insist that you ride in the cart and try to take it easy on the trip there.
Sure thing!
Good, good.
We can head to Vernon Keep, spend some time there resting, and it's a shorter walk towards the actual keep we need to take.
Now, I wonder what code one pals are.
My wagon is filled with provisions and stuff. It was part of the massive amount of money that I spent on it. And we haven't used it yet, so it's still probably packed full with goods and stuff.
Fantastic.
There's nothing else I want to do here.
Yeah, I'm good to move.
Wait, what about your...
My goblins.
Your goblins.
I'll probably, leave early and then meet up with you guys on the road. Because I got 7 goblins and Glug. Well, six goblins and Glug.
Zekart, I just want to say that I don't think your friends, I sort of make a little shaky look, your friends would go over too well in Vern Keep.
No, we'll stay out of Vern Keep, but they could help us take our objective.
True.
They're pretty, they're quiet, sneaky. I'm pretty sure they can climb.
I think up first. Olin, I think they would be, come up. I think people would like them. Goblins are cool. I mean, look at them. Look what they're doing. They're like, what are you doing?
Someone, and you say that, and then everyone turns and notices there is a goblin on the outskirts of town who just scampers back into the woods.
Look at that little scamp.
He's got like a human skull like in his hand or something.
What may be concerning...
It's actually a potato.
What may be concerning or actually puts you at ease a bit is that that wasn't one of your goblins.
He just knows his goblins. Like,
he's
bonded to them.
His goblins also all have a mark of, like, wolf pack on them.
Yeah. They're loyal.
Yeah. So I go to it's still in the morning, I guess, and I go to Argo, and I, you know, pat him down. That's my horse, by the way. Mm. I pat him down, and I, you know, tie him to the wagon, and I get ready to go. I want to give the innkeeper like a tip for having me for so long again.
Valdell's known you for a while, so he doesn't make you pay.
I give him like 10 gold or money, 10 money.
He accepts it. So I'm guessing that business Frederick worked out for you is going to keep you busy.
Aye, for most of a month it looks like. Unless we end it quickly.
Alright, well, best of luck, Weir. Come back safe and...
I'll be back soon.
Yeah, bring more tips.
Of course. Is Argo good? Yes. He's specifically trained to fight giant monsters.
Nice. So, whenever you guys leave town, I leave in a different direction and probably meet you along the road with all seven of them in tow.
I almost panic then because I thought there was about to be a Grimwood thing where however early you guys leave, I leave an hour early.
Incidentally, Snake.
Alright, so it's about a 5-hour trip.
There we go.
According to our pace.
Yeah, and because you're
following... You said we go three miles an hour.
Yeah, and because it's basically forest and things like that give you a negative modifier, but you're on a you're on a path that's been laid out, so yeah.
Okay.
Let's see. I've got Glug carrying the sack of potatoes, and I probably have Tar and Glug like up beside me carrying my shit.
You have names for all of them?
Yeah.
You're going to have to send me these names because I think I only named the vegetarian one.
Actually, Austin, the one can we make that canonically Glug?
Those are the names.
So it looks like that, but he's green and stuff.
Glug, Tar, Leonard. Alright, and Glug's the vegetarian one, if I'm remembering.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, alright, I'm also going to say that all of them speak in Goblin. Only Glug is capable, maybe Glad as well. Glug and Glad, so I will remember it easier. They're capable of some common.
Alright, I immediately promote them to leadership positions.
Mm. Yeah, but when you approach Glug, it's like, Zakat!
Yes, Glug. Friends.
Other goblins!
Oh yeah, you've seen the others then.
Running from creature. Big.
Big creature, bigger than me, or bigger than you?
Both.
I point to Argo. Bigger than Argo?
Is this after the way we've met up and stuff?
This is in the woods when he first goes to collect them.
Okay, it's just you then.
Okay. Yeah.
People too.
Let's see.
People too.
People too. Were the people on top of the big thing?
No.
No.
This was other moment.
Other moment. Okay, let's see. Let's focus on the big thing. The big thing. What color is the big thing?
Brown.
Big brown thing. How many legs does it walk on?
Too many.
Too many. So more than two?
Mm.
More than four?
Mm.
Less than four?
Mm. Mm,
how many is four? More than six? Four. I get down on all fours. Four.
Mm.
Is that a... Wait. Mm? Is that a good hmm or a no hmm?
Good.
Hmm. So more than four?
No.
Is four?
Yes.
Is it furry?
Hmm.
Ah, it's just probably a giant bear. We don't have to worry about that. Alright. No, let's see. The people... Or the people with the bear?
No. Other moment.
Other moment. Okay, tell me about this other moment.
Three.
You saw three of them? Alright, what were they wearing?
One like Sandal Man.
Sandal Man.
Okay, what about the other two?
He knows the word for sandal, but not robes, so you know, it's one of those.
My name is now Orlin Sandalman Brown.
And yes, then the other two?
Bo.
Hmm. Okay. What direction?
He kind of points in the direction of town. Weren't hunters.
Hmm. Good job, Glug. And I toss him like a radish.
He devours it. In a very unseeming, very, very impolite manner.
Great. Come along, Glug. Get your troops in order. We're marching.
Meh!
So yeah, they all follow you.
I feel like Sweech should voice the goblins.
Yeah, he should. He'd do a better job of it than I would. I just have to feed him lines.
Yeah, oh god. I will say
whatever, like, we have to control the goblins and they have to talk or something, we have control over it, you should give it to Swede to have that
duty. I turn back to Glug and say, Sandalman, what color was he?
Well, what color was he? I don't know.
Color.
Yes, I point to my shirt and say, brown. I point to him and say green.
Ah. He brown.
He very brown.
Hmm. Interesting. Like, okay. Let us march.
No.
So then we march up to the company.
That's actually the thing. Is Grosrick traveling with you as well? Because you were meeting with him to go up to...
Yeah.
What a sight, though.
I don't know what he's going to think of the goblins, but since I know that we're going to meet up with them, I would say that I tell him about them first.
Okay.
So he isn't just surprised.
Yeah, he's kind of a bit taken aback by that, but just says... He just kind of, like, laughs.
It's not the strangest, like, traveling companion I've ever had.
Yeah, but he does, like, he's a bit taken aback for a moment, like... Then he bursts out laughing and just says, they really are bloody adventurers, aren't they?
Believe me, the goblins weren't my idea.
Wait, then he realizes, who was it? Whose idea was it, the goblins?
Oh, you know Zakhart.
Yes, I do, but that's bizarre, even for him. He just kind of, like, takes a moment.
In the last few years, with the drinking and just...
Yes, he's truly gone off the deep end.
Somewhat. I believe he could be redeemed, though.
Yes, and don't worry, I'll keep it under my hat.
Good man. They're a bit eccentric, as goblins are wont to be, so just fair warning.
I'd be lying if I said the Rendals have never had goblins in their employ.
That doesn't surprise me either.
But no, so you all meet up, and yeah, it's what is going to follow is a 5-hour-long walk to just get to the crossroads.
Do you, like, relay to me what the goblin said?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm like, Orlin, strange sightings with Glug and Co.
When you mention, like, the giant brown beast, I'm like, I wonder if it could be that mammoth that we saw that attacked us.
Could be. Glug, come here.
Actually, that's a note. I thought they were like hilly creatures or plains creatures. Turns out they are forest. They were in forests mainly. Or at least Eric says they are.
What, mammoths?
Yeah.
Huh.
I have no idea though.
I wouldn't know.
Yeah. Yeah, but Glug comes over.
Glug, remember big brown furry thing?
Hmm.
I point to Argo. Is it bigger than that?
Hmm.
Alright, yeah, it could have been your mammoth.
I make a gesture, like, from my nose, like, making a trunk. Did it have one of these, like, something growing out of its face?
Hmm.
I look at Zachary. Is that a yes?
I believe that is a yes. No.
No?
No.
Yes. No.
I look at Glug and say, Glug, and I make like, I put my hands up to my mouth and do like tusks. Did it have these?
Mm-mm.
Alright. Not a mammoth.
Interesting. Okay. I'll keep that in mind.
Oh. Also, they spotted a couple of hunters and a man he described as yourself leaving a Holden clearing.
What sort of clothing was he wearing?
I looked at Glug and
he
say,
kinda, he runs over to, like, yours are tailored, like, but he kind of, like, grabs the robe. This, brown, not as nice.
Do I know any wizards that wear brown clothing?
Roll a smarts check, because this is kind of a general thing.
I also have Knowledge Arcana if that comes up at some point.
You probably couldn't smarts. Get like a good enough explanation of the robes off of...
No,
start painting an image.
I'm gonna use my extra Benny that I got to Benny this.
Okay.
Okay, there we go.
That was five. So, basically, Holden Clearing, the most simple explanation is basically, Holden Clearing is an adventurer's town. Most people, a lot of adventurers come through here either looking to go north to face the Red Forest and the Dragon, or they're going to Rendaleport to work as a mercenary for the army. But a lot of people do stop off and hunt in the nearby forests who aren't, you know, part of the lodge or anything like that. And I remember in the last session, you found a place where, like, knowing the roots of both the city guard and the hunters, you knew a place where the goblins wouldn't be spotted. But if it's just a few randoms, probably people were just looking to get some easy kills, get some easy loot.
Okay.
Damn experience grinders.
I see.
It's more a case that Valdau is basically told what local people need solved, but you also need some credit to your name. So just going out into the woods and showing, oh, I can kill some goblins is pretty much like writing a CV.
So I don't know anyone specifically who it could be, but I know generally why there might be people out there.
Yeah.
Okay.
That could be any number of people who see a goblin and go, yeah, I'm gonna kill that.
Right. I relay that to Zachard.
And nod and says, yeah, makes sense. See adventurers passing out there all the time.
Well, your goblins, they'll need to stay well away from Argo. He's not a particular fan of their kind.
And nod and say, not a problem.
The horse kind of watches them warily.
You do that, like, Zakart, like, into the walk, you do notice Glad, like, tugging at your arm.
Yes, Glad.
Meat.
Ah, of course, of course. I look over and say, Altar.
Yeah?
You notice any, tracks around?
Let me see.
I have some reserved provisions if you can't find any game.
Like, do I roll notice or tracking?
Tracking if you're trying to follow tracks. Like, yeah. You guys are walking down, like, a forest road with a canopy overhead, but, yeah, off to the side of the road, you do notice, like, what looked like deer tracks. You kind of, like, semi-circled around a tree, noticed it was a main road, and headed back into the forest quite recently.
So there's deers nearby.
Well, if you can go off hunting if you think it's a good idea, but I do have provisions in the cart.
Yeah, sure. Oh, wait. Yeah.
We do have a bit of a time limit here.
Alto was about to do it, but then he looked at his hand like, oh, yeah.
He just looked at his hand.
And he just sits in the cart like
his wrist.
I'll just be in the cart.
I go into the back of the cart.
If you wish to continue on the road, I can take the goblins out for a bonding experience. They can hunt on their own.
We can.
Very well. I wasn't particularly looking forward to giving them my good ham that I have back there.
Yes,
it's been marinating for a while.
I'm sure they prefer their food raw anyway. We'll keep your honeyed ham.
All right. Also, just official decree: I will voice the goblins occasionally, but Swede. Feel fucking free. See, he's better at it than I am. He's got more.
You
range.
Do the official like world RP stuff, and then Swede does the
flavor
random